language classroom. Learners, parents, teachers, we will continue the first lesson, Who Did Patrick's Homework, Part 3. In this lesson, we will understand the text, we will recall, recapitulate what has been learned in the first two lessons, understanding the text, then we will do the speaking activity and how to speak when you speak to someone. The third one will is a writing activity. Please to write, an idea to write. So with me is Kriti.
Hello.
She was there in the last two classes. So we will jointly do this. Before we move on to the lesson, let's understand the objectives or the learning outcomes of this lesson. At the end of this lesson, you learners will be able to read a variety of texts in English and identify main ideas, characters, sequence of ideas and events and relates with your personal experience. That's the way. Patrick's lesson we read, we understood. Now we also have experience that we are able to connect with that. Let me request Kriti to read the second and third objectives.
The learners would be able to respond to a variety of questions on familiar and unfamiliar texts, verbally and in writing. Use appropriate words to deduce meanings from clues in context while reading a variety of texts.
So we have learned some words and we will be using them in context. This is with reference to vocabulary and speaking. And with reference to writing, we will draft, revise, write short paragraphs based on verbal, print and visual cues. So the input, ideas, you may be asked, given a written text, a visual, we are going to write it. Then how we are going to do is, we will draft, jot down ideas, we will see that. It's called process approach to writing.
Okay.
And we write coherently with focus on appropriate beginning, middle and end. So like a good movie, there will be a beginning, middle and an end. So any story, you can notice it. So writing also. Okay, before we move on to the activities, let's summarize the story for your understanding, better understanding as well as our understanding.
Yeah.
Okay. Who did Patrick's homework? It's a kind of summary and subtext we are creating. Now, Kriti, why don't you read the summary of the story?
Sure, sir. So let's summarize the story. Patrick did not want to complete his homework because he hated homework and liked to play sports. One day, Patrick's cat caught an elf and was playing with it. Then the elf saw Patrick and promised Patrick to grant him a wish if Patrick saved him from the cat. Patrick agreed and told the elf that he had to complete all Patrick's homework till the end of the semester. The elf reluctantly agreed, but he told Patrick that he would need his help because the elf did not know how to do homework. Every day the elf asks Patrick's help by making Patrick to find the words in a dictionary or to add or subtract math problems.
Ultimately, he was doing it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Finally, on the last day, when the school was over, the elf slipped from the back door, and when the results were out, Patrick got A's.
Okay, we know very well, it's a very interesting kind of, very clever kind of thing.
Yes.
The elf did to Patrick. So, we know who did, and Patrick still blames he has done the work.
Yes.
Okay, now, let's look at this screen and see some of the usages which Patrick uses or the writer of the story uses to convey meaning. So notice the following expressions in the story. Let me read out. Homework, too boring. He played hockey and basketball and Nintendo instead. Look at Kriti, do you notice homework too boring? In spoken English, we often do not say full sentences.
Full sentences.
Suppose sometimes the friends walk, we say, coming?
Yeah.
What does it mean? Are you coming?
Yeah.
So, this kind of expressions writers use and we use the real life usages.
Scenarios, yes.
Suppose you say, joking? I don't believe it.
Yeah.
So, those kinds of things. So, supposing the above sentence, homework too boring, he played hockey and basketball and Nintendo instead. can be expanded and written like this. He did not like to do homework because he found it very boring. Instead of it, he liked to play hockey and basketball and Nintendo. So, but the writer has to convey pragmatic
and
real life conversation.
Yes.
So that is not very formal.
Mm.
So learners, let's understand when we speak, when we write a dialogue for a movie, a drama, it's actually people's act.
Mm.
We call it speech act. Speech is an act.
Yeah.
We discussed in the last lesson also. So let's learn how the author is using this. So here are some such usages for you. Kirti, could you read out?
Yes. Joking. It has no substance. I do not believe this. Kidding. Be serious. Our teacher will be here now. Writing letters. Boring. I go for email. Stay away from mobile phone. It is spoiling children.
Fine. I'm reading out again. Joking. It has no substance. I don't believe this. Joking.
Yeah.
Then look at again. Kidding. Be serious. Our teacher will be here now. When the teacher comes, the class becomes very serious.
Yeah.
Writing letters, boring. I'll go for email.
Yeah.
Stay away from mobile phones. It's spoiling children.
Okay.
How this can be written? Let's see. One after another, how they are expanded. Joking. It has no substance. I don't believe this. How this can be written? Kriti?
Are you joking? I do not believe in whatever you have said. It has no substance.
Kidding? Be serious. Our teacher will be here now.
Don't behave like a kid. You should be serious and the teacher is reaching our class now.
Fine. This is how it's expected. Look at the other sentence. Very, very interesting. Writing letters boring. I go for email.
I do not like to write letters as it makes me bored.
Okay. And I'll write emails.
I write emails.
Stay away from mobile phone. It's spoiling children.
Don't spend much time on mobile phones because it is spoiling children.
Okay. When we speak in any language, this kind of things happen. We use, and that makes the conversation, dialogue, any play, short story interesting. That's what we call it authentic writing, natural writing. It makes language natural. And if you really recall children, learners, you find we never feel that we think when we speak in our mother tongue.
Yes.
We get angry.
Yeah.
It comes all in a second. And sometimes when we learn English or any foreign language, we feel that, oh, I have to find a word and say.
Yes.
So actually, when we learn English for 12 years, we should also be able to speak English language or any other second language, foreign language, as naturally. As our mother tongue
language.
So, for that, we need to go for natural language.
Mm.
That natural language is the way we are speaking.
Yes.
It's a formal language.
Yes.
Children speak, go asking for something. So, we will see it later. Now, this is what children you should know. When you speak, someone speaks on the television, in the real life conversation, you may notice such usages. We will come to that later. Now, Patrick feels bored. Kriti?
Yes.
He was very, very bored and said, I don't want to do homework.
Yeah.
Let me play. I something like that. He says, I play basketball, this, that. Patrick feels bad about doing homework.
Yes, of course
he does. Says, what he says?
Patrick feels bad about doing homework. He says, homework boring.
Homework is so boring.
So boring.
So, it's his expression of his feelings about his dislike towards homework.
Yes.
Sometimes, you know, we generally say, I don't like this, particularly food, you know, eating it. Sometimes, I don't like this, particularly I don't like this. So, it's a kind of feeling.
Yeah.
I love to play cricket or I love to play this, hockey.
Yeah.
So, you may have the feelings of dislike towards homework. Think and discuss with your partner and write your feeling about homework. So, we are going to write now here as we do the class.
Okay.
Your feeling about likes or dislikes about homework. So, I'm not going to ask you, come on, start writing.
Hmm.
That will be very mechanical exercise. There's a process involved in writing. What is the process involved? Let's see. When you write something, what do you do? You should have what? Ideas.
Ideas, yes.
Then you should have?
Instincts. Naturally, words should come out.
Then you gather ideas to write.
Yes.
So we are going to now write our feelings against homework or for homework,
mm-hmm.
or you may have 2-3 points against homework, you may have 2-3 points for homework. But it's not that all homework is bad.
Mm-hmm.
Though in 1993, Government of India, and even in 2005, NCERT, Government of India came out that don't give homework up to class 4. That's fine because children have to play whatever learned. But there is a mixed feeling how much homework should be given. So we will write, how we will write, let us discuss. There's a process involved when you write it. So what you do, I request the ask the learners that follow this process when you write anything. First, what we do, we brainstorm to collect ideas. Suppose if I ask you, Kriti, how will you do? You have to write a paragraph, which is meaningful, about expressing your dislike.
Okay.
About homework. How will you do that? First, gather ideas.
Yeah, I will start thinking about why don't I like homework or why I do like homework. Then I will start, appointing the
points. What would be your first point?
Why I don't like?
Yes.
Okay. So, because it is very tedious. It takes away a lot of time and we don't get enough time to play or do our extracurricular activities.
Okay. Now you brainstormed yourself.
Yeah.
So, if you have to write, then jot down your ideas.
Yes.
Then, having jotted down, let us say, 5 points you have jotted down. It takes away my play time.
Yeah.
My mother always scolds me for not doing homework.
Yes.
Then, and I take time till the end of the day, 10 o'clock, 8 o'clock, I wait, then I start doing in a hurry.
Hmm.
So these are the ideas you have jotted down. You
yes.
have to write down in pointers, in sentences,
yes.
not sentences, in words.
Okay.
Now, you've got a lot of ideas with you,
hmm.
but you do not know which idea will go where. So,
okay.
Make an outline.
Yes, yes, sir.
It appears on the screen. You will say brainstorm, jot down the ideas, then make an outline. Now, outline is done.
Hmm.
I don't like because this.
Yeah.
Then write the ideas into sentences. Which sentence will come first? Then you have to say, I don't like homework because one, then, so write sentences. So now you have got the first draft with you. Then revise the first draft. You have revised. Oh, now again rework. You revised it. Proofread it. Edit it. Then write the final
draft.
So
yes.
Now it appears on the screen. This is called a process approach to writing. There's a process involved. So I'm going to say the steps. You read out what learners are expected to do.
Okay.
Brainstorming.
Jot down as many ideas as you can about a given topic, then arrange the ideas in a sequence.
Outlining.
Create an outline for your writing. Which ideas will go first? How will they be supported by evidence? Will there be a picture, etc.?
Okay. Drafting.
Write first draft. Here the focus is on the content and not the form.
Let me also say something about it. When you just write the first draft, you don't bother how good the sentence is. Suppose some spelling mistakes, some grammar mistakes. Ignore it because now ideas are important.
Hmm.
Then comes revising.
Revise the first draft, improve it, add or delete ideas and improve the language.
Now this is very most important thing. You revise, put it in the order and rearrange it. Then proofreading.
Proofread the draft with the help of the teacher. Here the focus is on the form and not the content.
Okay, you have got the ideas. Now, accuracy, grammatical mistakes, how sentences are formed, whether the sentence is correct. So, everything you are actually doing. Here we have said you may take the help of the teacher.
Teacher, yes.
The reason is because teacher would sometimes, you may overlook some of the mistakes.
Hmm.
So, that's one. Then the final draft.
Yeah. Write the final draft now.
So learners, so process approach to writing, the processes on one side and the expectations what learners do on the other side. So it starts from brainstorming to final draft. We have described it. Dear learners, when you do the work, this lesson, write a paragraph or two, adopting the following the process approach to write. So this is how a good write-up will emerge as a result of the processes you have been adopted. Otherwise, what happens? Writing, particularly any learning, does not happen in vacuum. Generally, what say, write an essay about yourself. I remember the most popular paragraph writing was rainy day. Even that children were asked to write where places there are no rains,
no
like
rains.
Rajasthan.
Okay.
So that is a mechanical way of doing things. So we learn when we think something, when we start gathering ideas. So it also exercises our this
brain.
One. Suppose don't worry if you don't find, if you don't get the proper words and sentences. Suppose I would suggest learners, suppose I am writing a sentence in which the particular word I am not getting in English, you write it in Hindi while drafting. So you may consult the dictionary. I am saying how one learns to write well. You may ask, how can I do it in the examination? If you do every month one good write up like this, following this process approach, ultimately from class 6 onwards in the examinations you will be writing well, and otherwise also you will be writing well. Okay. Before we close this lesson on the last part of Patrick, who did Patrick's homework, here are three topics for you on which you can work and develop your write-up, adopting the process approach, this process approach which appears on your screen. So here are the topics. Kriti, read out.
Sure. So topic number one, mobile phones, boon or bane?
Mobile phones, a boon or bane. Mobile phones have become now a necessity.
Yes.
Everybody has.
Yes.
It's a boon in one way.
Yeah.
But on the other hand, it's a curse.
Yeah.
It takes away our time. So come on learners, you may take a stand. You say that mobile phones are boon to society. Write a paragraph. Or if you say that no, it's a ban, it takes time, it troubles us and parents scold us, this, that, and unnecessary things also come, every second one WhatsApp message comes, it has no relevance to me, so write about it. But brainstorm, jot down your ideas, create an outline, draft, revise,
and then final.
So this is what process approach.
Yes.
And mobile phones, boon or bane.
The second topic is fast food, problem and benefits.
Okay, you know.
Yeah.
Fast food. So they will write.
The third topic is parents' expectation of children.
So parents expect many things for children.
Yes.
You should play, you should go for art class, this, that, and you become engineer, doctor. So as a child, class 6 child, you are 10, 12 or 11 years old, how do you understand this? Gather ideas, outline, then write. Okay, Kriti, we have come to the close of the lesson. What do we expect learners to do after this lesson? We have got three parts given,
yes,
delivered. So we expect learners, please read the story Patrick.
Yes.
Who did Patrick's homework, and do the summary and the speaking activity and writing activity. What are all we have done? Thank you very much.
Thank you
for participating. So we will come with the next lesson in our next one.